Magical Fantasy 6. In this game workshop, we're going to create Magical Fantasy image number 6. The download link for the images is in the video description. Part 1, the background. When GIMP is open, we open our image folder. Select all 8 images. Then click and drag the first image into GIMP. In this way, they will all open as separate images, with the sand dune image as the first one. Click on Layer in the menu bar, Transparency, and hit Add Alpha Channel. Activate the Free Select tool. Make a selection of the sky and stay well within the boundaries of the dunes. All blue should be included. Zoom in and out by pressing the Control key and simultaneously rolling the mouse wheel. When we press and hold the spacebar, we can move the image by moving the mouse without clicking. When we are back at the first node, we click in it and then we double click in the selection to confirm. Go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Now we go to Select and click Feather. We feather the selection with 30 pixels and click OK. Click on Edit and then on Clear to remove the background. Then to Select and None to deselect the selection. Make in the toolbox the Scale tool active. Place the mouse pointer more or less in the center of the image. Now zoom out a bit. Click in the image. Scale the image like shown in the video. It's okay to have a bit transparency at the bottom, but not at the sides. We will fill in the transparency later. Click Scale. Go to Layer and click Layer to Image Size. Press Ctrl-Shift-J to maximize the image again. Now we go to the toolbox and we make the Blur Sharpen tool active. Choose Brush Hardness 0.25. Make the size about 200. And we make the Force as well as the Rate 100. Then we can make the top of the dunes unsharp like so. Click and drag the thumbnail of the sky image via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into the project. Click and drag this layer below the sand dunes layer. Double click on the name and rename it Sky. Hit Enter. Now we activate the scale tool again. In the tool options we make the image opacity about 50. Click in the image. Then we scale the sky like so. And when it's to our liking, we click Scale. Go to Layer and hit Layer to Image Size. Go to Color and Brightness and Contrast. Reduce the brightness to about negative 50. Click OK. Click and drag the thumbnail of the sand via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into the project. Click and drag this layer to the top of the layer stack. Then we double click on the name and rename it Sand. Hit Enter. Click the Scale tool active. Zoom out a bit and scale the sand more or less like so. Then click Scale. Activate the Eraser tool. There is still brush 0.25 and the size should still be about 200. Erase on the left and the right of the image some areas like shown in the video. We can leave the middle area as it is because that's where the tiger will come. When this looks okay, we go to Layer and hit Layer to Image Size. We do this so we don't see the yellow lines anymore, but it's not necessary. Again to Colors, Brightness and Contrast. Now we reduce the brightness to about negative 60. Click OK. And there we have our background. Part 2. The tiger. In the next step we will work on the tiger. Click on its thumbnail. Go to Layer, Transparency and hit Add Alpha Channel. Activate in the toolbox the Scissor Select tool. Zoom in and start clicking notes like so. Use the spacebar in combination with the mouse to move the image. When the selection is not accurate, we can just click on a line and move it. Or we can move a note. The selection doesn't need to be perfect. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go a bit fast forward. When we are back at the first note, we click the last note over the first note. We can still make corrections if necessary. Now click in the selection to confirm. Press Ctrl+Shift+J again. Then press Ctrl+I to invert the selection so the background is selected. Then press the Delete key to remove the background. And finally, press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect the selection. Click on the Smudge tool. Choose Brush Bristles 02. The size should be about 50 or 60. Zoom in and start smudging the edge of the fur like so. With Ctrl+Z, we can undo previous made steps. And with Ctrl+Y we can redo them again. Try to follow the flow of the hair. We will again go a bit fast forward. Think it's okay, we press Ctrl+Shift+J. Go ahead and click and drag the thumbnail of the tiger via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into the project. Make sure that it is on the top of the layer stack. Then we double click on the name and rename it Tiger. Hit Enter. Click on the Unify Transform tool. Make the image opacity about 50. At Constrain, we check the option Scale. Now click in the image. Zoom out a bit and scale the tiger by moving the top, the bottom and the side handles, like so. Click and drag outside the framework to rotate the tiger just a little bit. Click and drag inside the framework to move the whole image. When you think it looks okay, we click Transform. Press Ctrl+Shift+J. Click on Layer and on Layer to Image Size. Go to Colors and Color Balance. Here we make the cyan red value plus 5 and the yellow blue value negative 20. Click OK. Again to Colors and now to Curves. We adjust the curves to make the tiger a bit more expressive, like so. Click OK. Right-click on the tiger layer and hit Alpha to Selection. In this way, we select everything in this layer that's not transparent. Press Ctrl+Shift+N to make a new layer. Name it Shadow Tiger. The mode should be normal. And we make the fill width option Transparency. Then we can click OK. This layer is now active and the selection is applied to this layer. Drag the black of the foreground background colors into the image. In the next step, we make the Unified Transform tool active again. At Constrain, we uncheck both the Scale and the Shear option. Click in the image. Make the top layer invisible by clicking its eye. Zoom out a bit by placing the mouse pointer in the top of the image. In that way, we get space below the image. Now we transform the shadow, like shown in the video. When we think it looks okay, we can click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Anchor the floating layer. Make it visible. And move it one place down in the layer stack. Reduce the opacity to about 70. Go to Filters in the menu bar. Click Blur and then Gaussian Blur. Make the blur radius 5. And click OK. Make the tiger layer active. In the next step, we will add some more shadows. Press Ctrl-Shift-N, and now we name the new layer Shadow Tiger 2. Click OK. Go to the toolbox and make the paintbrush active. Change the opacity to about 30. Choose brush hardness 0.25. And make the size about 150. Add some shadows where the tiger touches the ground, like so. Then we click on the foreground button of the foreground background colors to make the color palette visible. Fill in the HTML notation F, F, C, 3, 2, A, and click OK to confirm. Right-click on the tiger layer and hit Alpha to selection again. We can now paint a bit of an orange glow on the shoulders and the back of the tiger. We can change the size as well as the opacity to our liking. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect and make the top layer active. Part 3, the girl. Drag the thumbnail of the girl image via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into the project. Double-click on the name and rename it girl. Hit enter. Click on the flip tool and then in the image to flip the image. Then we click on the scale tool and in the image. Make sure that the chain is locked so the proportions stay intact when we scale the image. Go ahead and scale the image. Move it by click and drag the center square to its proper position. When everything looks okay, we click scale. Right-click on the girl layer and hit Alpha to selection. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Name it Shadow Girl and click OK. Reset the foreground background colors to their default. Then drag the black into the image. Make the Unified Transform tool active and click in the image again. Make the top layer invisible by clicking its eye. Zoom out a bit. Now we transform the shadow, like shown in the video. When we think it looks okay, we can click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Anchor the floating layer. Make it visible. And move it one place down in the layer stack. Then reduce the opacity to about 70. Go to Filters and click Repeat Gaussian Blur. Activate the girl layer. Click on Colors and then on Color Temperature. We make the original value 4000. and click OK. Now hit the Eraser tool. Swap the foreground background color so we get white as our foreground color. Make sure that the opacity is 100 and the brush is 0.25. We make the size about 50. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Leave the option White Full Opacity checked and click Add. Now we zoom into the foot of the girl. Erase just enough to make the impression that her foot is in the fur of the tiger. Hit Ctrl-Shift-J once more. Make the image instead of the layer mask active. The white border shows that it is active. Right-click on the layer and click on Alpha to Selection. Make the paintbrush active. Click on the foreground color and then on the orange color that we've used on the tiger. Hit OK. We make the opacity about 20. Now we zoom in to the face and the dress. We make an orange glow on her face and on the front of the dress like so. We can play with the size if we want. Then we reset the foreground background colors. Make the size of the brush about 100. Zoom out a bit and make the side and the back of the girl a bit darker. Don't forget to include her leg and the cat at her foot. When you think it looks good, we hit Ctrl-Shift-J and then Ctrl-Shift-A. Part 4. More cats. Time now to bring in some more cats. Drag the thumbnail of the three cats via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into our project. Rename it Three Cats. Then we click on the Scale tool and in the image. Scale and reposition the image like so. Then click Scale. Right-click on the Three Cats layer and hit Alpha to Selection. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Name it Three Cats Shadow and click OK. Click and drag the black into the image. Then we make the Unified Transform tool active again. Now click in the image and then transform the shadow like shown in the video. When we feel it's what we want, we click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Anchor the floating layer and move it one place down in the layer stack. Reduce the opacity to about 70. Now we go to Filters, Blur and Gaussian Blur again. We blur the shadow with 5 points and click OK. Activate the Three Cats layer. Click on Colors and Color Temperature. Here too we make the original value 4000 and click OK. Drag the thumbnail of the last cat image via the thumbnail of the sand dunes into the project. Double click on the name and rename it One Cat. Hit Enter to confirm. Click the Flip tool active and click in the image to flip it. Click on the Scale tool and in the image. Scale and reposition the image. When it looks OK, we click Scale. Right-click on the One Cat layer and click Alpha to Selection. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Rename this one One Cat Shadow and click OK. Click and drag the black into the image. make the Unified Transform tool active, and click in the image. Zoom out a bit, and transform this shadow. When we feel it looks okay, we click Transform. Press Ctrl+Shift+J. Anchor the floating layer and move it one place down in the layer stack. Reduce the opacity to about 70. Go to Filters, Blur and Gaussian Blur. Blur this shadow also with 5 points and click OK. Activate the one cat layer. Click on Colors and Color Temperature. We make the original value again 4000 and click OK. Part 5, the finishing touch. Now we bring the bird into the project. Rename the layer Birds. Click the Scale tool and click in the image. Scale the image and move it to its proper position. Then click Scale to apply the effect. Now we make the mode darken only, so only the darker pixels remain visible. Press Ctrl+Shift+N. Rename it Vignette and click OK. Activate the paintbrush and make the opacity about 50. We choose brush hardness 0.25 and we make the size about 900. Then we make a vignette like so. To finish off, we select the tiger layer. Then we go to Colors and Color Temperature. Here we make the original temperature 4500 and click OK. Back to Colors and now to use Saturation. We reduce the saturation with 10 and click OK. In this way the color of the tiger matches the surrounding area much better. And there we have it, our magical fantasy image number 6. I hope you have fun with this tutorial. Please like it and maybe leave a nice comment to support this channel. Thank you very much for watching.